إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الكلام كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا. الله سبحانه وتعالى in his Quran he commands the believers to glorify him and to praise him and to remember him throughout the day and night. He said subhanahu wa ta'ala, O you who believe, اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with continuous, frequent remembrances. وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا. And praise and glorify him at the beginning of the day and the end of the day. Allah jalla wa ala did not only command the believers to remember him, but he commanded the believers to remember him subhanahu wa ta'ala frequently. So when he mentioned the believing men and women, and he was praising the believing men and women, he said regarding them, وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. And the men and the women that frequently remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has prepared for them a great reward. He has prepared for them a great reward. And we find when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the hypocrites in the Quran, those who portray Islam but they hide disbelief and hypocrisy in their hearts, he said regarding them, وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. They do not remember Allah except for a little. To show that even the hypocrites remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But one of the things that distinguishes between them and the believers is that the believers frequently remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while the hypocrites only rarely remember Allah jalla wa ala. We also find in the hadith of Abdullah ibn Musa radiyallahu anhu, which is in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad, he said, أَتَى النَّبِيَّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ رَجُلٌ. A man came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, O Messenger of Allah, إِنَّ شَرَائِعَ الْإِسْلَامِ قَدْ كَثُرَتْ عَلَيْنَا فَبَابٌ نَتَمَسَّكُ بِهِ جَامِعٌ. He said, O Messenger of Allah, indeed the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has legislated, they are too many for us to do. Is there anything that if we were to do it, it would be as if we have done everything? This companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is asking a very important question. He said, O Messenger of Allah, the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has legislated are too many for us to do, meaning the voluntary actions. There are so many voluntary actions. What is the greatest of them? Is there any of these actions that if we were to do them, it will be as if we have done all of the voluntary actions? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا يزال لسانك رطبا من ذكر الله عز وجل. As long as your tongue is moist with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As long as your tongue is moist with the remembrance of Allah jalla wa ala, it will be as if you have encompassed all of the good deeds and all of the sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his legislations jalla wa ala. We also find in the hadith of Abi Huraira radiyallahu anhu, which is in the Sahihain, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, So he's quoting a hadith on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah jalla wa ala, he said, أَنَا عِنْدَ ظَنِّ عَبْدِي بِي وَأَنَا مَعَهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي. I am just as my slave thinks I am, and I am with him when he remembers me. What does this hadith mean? I am just as my slave thinks I am. Meaning if we have good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will be just like that. If we believe he will grant us our request, he will grant it. If we believe that he will be merciful to us and forgive us, he will be merciful to us and forgive us. But if we lose hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he will not be there for us. So he said, أَنَا عِنْدَ ظَنِّ عَبْدِي بِي. I am just as my slave thinks of me. وَأَنَا مَعَهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي. And I am with him if he remembers me. I am with him if he remembers me. فَإِنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي نَفْسِهِ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي نَفْسِي. وَإِنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي مَلَئٍ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي مَلَئٍ خَيْرٍ مِّنْهُمْ. He said, if he remembers me by himself, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and I remember him by myself. And if he remembers me in front of a gathering, then I remember him in front of a gathering which is better than his gathering. So Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala, when he explained this, he said, it is better for a slave of Allah jalla wa ala to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in secret by himself, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember this person by himself without the presence of the angels. So even the angels will be shocked about his greatness when he stands on Yawm al-Qiyamah. But if he remembers him in a gathering of people, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention his name in the gathering of the angels. And the gatherings of the angels will be better than the gathering of the people that are on this earth. So remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has great virtue and reward in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said jalla wa ala in the Quran, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Remember me and I will remember you. We as weak, disobedient slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do we deserve to be remembered by Allah jalla wa ala? Of course we don't. But out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah jalla wa ala said, if you remember me, I will remember you. Imagine Allah jalla wa ala remembering us by name, or mentioning us by name to the angels, or praising us in front of the greatest of the angels because we remembered him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is from the great virtues of remembering Allah jalla wa ala. And there are many ayat in the Quran and many hadith in the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that show and emphasize the importance and the greatness of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of the scholars of Islam, and from them Imam al-Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, when we stand on Yawm al-Qiyamah in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the believers will not regret anything more than all of the time that has gone by and they did not remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we truly reflect over the statement of al-Hasan al-Basri, we find that sometimes we are just sitting for hours, or we are walking outside, or we are driving in our cars, and hours have gone by and we have not even said subhanallah once. We have not said Allahu Akbar once, or la ilaha illallah, or any other form of remembrance. All of these hours, they have gone by and we cannot show for it in the hereafter. We do not have nothing for these hours that have gone by to put on our scales of good deeds in the hereafter. So if we fell short on good deeds, then we will regret this time. And even if our good deeds were very high on Yawm al-Qiyamah, we will still regret this time because it could have made us higher in Jannah. And we could have become more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let not our time pass except that we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we know the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha, that she said regarding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ فِي كُلِّ أَحْيَانِهِ. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always used to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He always remembered Allah jalla wa ala in all of his affairs. He would glorify and praise and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, he would stand in the night for such long prayers until his feet would begin to swell. And when the Sahaba saw him like this, they said, O Messenger of Allah, why are you doing this to yourself? Haven't you been forgiven for all of your sins? That when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're not going to have any sins. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Should I not be a thankful slave? He would worship Allah jalla wa ala to thank him. He would worship Allah jalla wa ala to glorify him and to remember him. Even though he knew he was going to enter paradise and not only enter paradise, but he is the master of the children of Adam. And he will be the first to enter paradise. And he will have the great intercession on Yawm al-Qiyamah. He wanted to thank Allah Jalla wa Ala by remembering him more and by worshipping him more. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what are the remembrances that we can remember Allah Jalla wa Ala with? I will give a few remembrances insha'Allah ta'ala so we can make it practical. So we can begin to implement this as soon as we leave the masjid and become closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The greatest remembrance is the Qur'an. The greatest remembrance is the Qur'an. There is nothing greater to remember Allah Jalla wa Ala with than what that which he spoke with subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Qur'an is the greatest remembrance. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he spoke about the Qur'an, he said, for every letter you recite, you will be received. You will receive 10 rewards. So Alif is 10 rewards. And Lam is 10 rewards. And Mim is 10 rewards. And this is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That for any good deed that we do, it is multiplied by 10 times. A minimum of 10 times. Up to 700 times. Up to even more, depending on the level of sincerity and concentration that we have. So the Qur'an is special. And the reward for reciting the Qur'an is special. For every letter you recite in the Qur'an, it will be multiplied by 10 times as a minimum. So we should recite as much Qur'an as we can. And this is from the greatest remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We also find in the hadith of Abi Huraira radiyallahu anhu wa arda, which is in the Sahih of Imam Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لَأَنْ أَقُولُ, for me to say, سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ وَلَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ. These beautiful words, Subhanallah, praise be to Allah, وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ, and glory be to Allah, وَلَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, and none has the right to be worshipped except Allah, وَاللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ, and Allah is the greatest. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا طَلَعَتْ عَلَيْهِ الشَّمْسِ. It is more beloved to me than everything the sun has risen on. Meaning these four phrases. If we were to say this, it is more beloved to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam than this entire earth and what it contains. And look at the goodness that we find in this earth. And the things that we desire from this earth. From this creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To say these four words are more beloved to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam than everything the sun has risen on. So imagine how great this will be on Yawm al-Qiyamah. And how heavy this will be on the scales. And how much this will raise you in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jannah. Beloved words to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they are beloved words to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has also taught us words that would make it easier for us to turn back to Allah and repent to Him. He said in the hadith of Abi Huraira radiyallahu anhu wa arda, which is in the Sahihain, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ قَالَ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَبِحَمْدِهِ فِي يَوْمٍ مِئَةَ مَرَّةٍ. Whoever says, سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَبِحَمْدِهِ, praise be to Allah and glory be to Him. And how easy is it for us to say this? سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَبِحَمْدِهِ. Whoever says this 100 times in the day. And this, brothers and sisters, will take no more than 2 minutes of our time. Just going back to our home, we can say more than 100 times. Whoever says this 100 times in a day, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حُطَّتْ خَطَايَاهُ وَإِنْ كَانَتْ مِثْلَ زَبَدِ الْبَحَرِ. His sins will be forgiven, even if they are equivalent to the foam on the sea. 2 minutes of our time to have this amount of sins forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By saying Subhanallah wa bihamdihi 100 times. This is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us our religion, so we can become close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we can be raised as true believers, those who remember Allah jalla wa ala, by continuously praising Him and glorifying Him throughout the day and night. Say this 100 times. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to encourage us to say this 100 times every day. So we can have our sins removed daily, and we can be cleansed daily, and we can become more and more beloved to our Creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We also find another hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is also the hadith of Abi Hurairah in the Sahihain. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من قال, whoever said, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. And most of you have memorized these remembrances. And if you haven't, you can take some of the books, inshallah, that can be given out after the salah. And you can find these remembrances in there, inshallah ta'ala. Whoever says this, La ilaha illallah, none has the right to be worshipped except Allah. Wahdahu, him alone. La sharika lah, he has no partners. Lahu al-mulku wa lahu al-hamd, for him belongs the kingdom and all praises. Wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir, and he is able to do all things. Whoever says this 100 times in the day, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كانت له عدلا عشر رقاب, it will be equivalent to freeing 10 slaves. It will be equivalent to freeing 10 slaves. In fact, in another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever frees a slave, for every part of the body of that slave that is free, his body will be freed from the fire of Jahannam. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever says this remembrance, La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la, lahu al-mulku wa lahu al-hamdu wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir, 100 times in the day, 10 slaves will be freed. And this is only the first reward that is mentioned. 10 slaves will be freed. This is the reward he will receive. وَكُتِبَ لَهُ مِئَةُ حَسَنَةً, and 100 good deeds will be written down for him. And none of us know the magnitude of these deeds. وَمُحِيَتْ عَنْهُ مِئَةُ سَيِّئَةً, and 100 sins will be removed from his scales. And we do not know the magnitude of these sins. وَكَانَتْ لَهُ حِرْزًا مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ يَوْمَهُ ذَلِكَ حَتَّى يُمْسِي, and he will be protected from the shaytan for the entire day until the night falls. He will be protected from the shaytan for the entire day until the night falls. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam concluded this by saying, وَلَمْ يَأْتِ أَحَدٌ بِأَفْضَلَ مِمَّا جَاءَ إِلَّا رَجُلٌ عَمِلَ أَكْثَرَ مِنْهُ, and no one will come with anything better than him on Yawm al-Qiyamah, except for the one who has said this more than he has. No one will come on Yawm al-Qiyamah better than him, except for the one who has said this more than he has. If we were to say this 100 times, perhaps it will take us 10 minutes, perhaps even less than this. But when we are walking, when we are driving, when we are in the bus or in the train, and we just continuously move our tongues to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like this, it could be the difference between our Jannah and our Jahannam, our paradise and our hell. Or it could be the difference between the lowest station of paradise and the highest station of paradise. This is how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has encouraged us to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our own benefits. Because it does not benefit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all. It only benefits us, and it only helps us, and it only makes us beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We also find in the hadith of Abi Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu, which is also in the Sahihain, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, أَلَا أَدُلُّكَ عَلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ مِّنْ كَنْزٍ مِّنْ كُنُوزِ الْجَنَّةِ, should I not inform you of a phrase which is a treasure from the treasures of Jannah? A phrase which is a treasure from the treasures of Jannah. Imagine having a treasure from the treasures of Jannah on your tongue. And imagine having a treasure from the treasures of Jannah prepared for you in the hereafter because you said this phrase that was beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Bala ya Rasulallah, yes, O Messenger of Allah, tell me this phrase which is a treasure from the treasures of Jannah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. There is no power and might except by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Acknowledging our weakness and all greatnesses with Allah. All power belongs to Him and all might belongs to Him. And we are unable to do anything except by His leave and His permission, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Thinking about the greatness of Allah jalla wa ala. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. This is a treasure from the treasures of Jannah. O brothers and sisters in Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has also taught us how to decorate our Jannah. This is our only chance to decorate our Jannah, to beautify our Jannah, to increase the size of our Jannah and what we have there. So he said to us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the hadith of Jabir radiallahu anhu in the Sunan of Imam al-Tirmidhi. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من قال سبحان الله العظيم وبحمده غنست له نخلة في الجنة. Whoever says سبحان الله العظيم وبحمده, praise be to Allah the greatest and glory be to Him, a palm tree will be planted for him in Jannah. You want 10 palm trees or 100 palm trees or 1,000 palm trees, it is up to you. The more you glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more you will decorate your Jannah. The more you will beautify your Jannah. The more when you enter Jannah, you will be astonished. Yes, the minimum Jannah is greater than this earth by 10 times. But you are going to be there for eternity. So just like we strive day and night to beautify our houses and to decorate our houses, let us strive day and night to beautify our eternal abode, to beautify our Jannah, our paradise, our gardens that Allah Jalla wa Ala has prepared for the believers. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، قال الله سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا. Allah Jalla wa Ala has commanded us believers. He said, O you who believe, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with frequent remembrances. And remember Him at the beginning and the end of the days. There is an amazing hadith that we find also in the Sahihain of Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu wa ardah. And when we think about this hadith, it encourages us to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more. And it encourages us to go to places and gatherings where the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is being mentioned, and where our Lord and Creator and Provider is being glorified. From the hadith of Abi Hurairah, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَلَائِكَ يَطُوفُونَ فِي الطُّرُقِ يَلْتَمِسُونَ أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has angels. And these angels, they traverse the earth looking for people who are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Angels have different roles given to them by Allah Jalla wa Ala. Like Jibreel alayhi salam was the angel, or is the angel who is responsible for the revelation given by Allah Jalla wa Ala. And Mikael is the angel who pushes the rain to certain places. And Allah Jalla wa Ala has angels that write our deeds. And from the angels that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created, their role is to traverse this earth looking for people who are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Looking for those who are glorifying Him and who are praising Him. Looking for those who are saying Subhanallah and Alhamdulillah. Looking for those who are reciting Quran and remembering Allah Jalla wa Ala. Inna lillahi malaika. Indeed, Allah Jalla wa Ala has angels. Yatufuna fi turuqi yaltamisuna ahla dhikr. They are traversing the earth looking for people who are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fa'idha wajadu qawman yadhkuruna Allah. If they find a people that are remembering Allah, تنادوا, they begin to shout and call. هَلُمُّوا إِلَى حَاجَتِكُمْ هَلُمُّوا إِلَى حَاجَتِكُمْ. These are the people that you are looking for. These are the people that you are looking for. فَيَحُفُّونَهُمْ بِأَجْنِحَتِهِمْ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا. Then they encircle them with their wings until they reach the skies of this world. They encircle them with their wings until they reach the skies of this world. فَيَسْأَلُهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ وَهُوَ أَعْلَمُ مِنْهُمْ مَا يَقُولُ عِبَادِي. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He asked them, even though He knows more than them, and He knows exactly what they are going to say. He asked them subhanahu wa ta'ala because He wants us to know about this conversation that is taking place. He asked them subhanahu wa ta'ala because He wants us to know the virtues of those who remember Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the angels, they encircle themselves around the gathering that is remembering Allah jalla wa ala, until they reach the skies of this world. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked them, even though He knows more than them, what are my slaves saying? So the angels, they say, يسبحونك ويكبرونك ويحمدونك ويمجدونك. They are saying subhanallah. They are saying alhamdulillah. They are saying Allahu Akbar. They are magnifying you, O Allah. This is what your slaves, they are saying. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, هل رأوني. Have they seen me? These slaves of Allah Jalla wa Ala glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such a manner. Have they seen Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So the angels, they say, لا والله ما رأوا. No, by Allah, they have not seen you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to them, وكيف لو أنهم رأوني. How would they be if they had seen me? So the angels, they say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لو أنهم رأوا. If they had seen you, كانوا أشد لك عبادة. They would worship you even more. وَأَشَدَّ لَكَ تَمْجِيدًا. And they would magnify you more. وَأَكْثَرَ لَكَ تَسْبِيحًا. And they would praise you even more. This is how the angels respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah Jalla wa Ala is telling the angels, I have created slaves that have not seen me, yet they are worshipping me. Imagine if they had seen me, how they would worship me. So this is how the angels, they respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah Jalla wa Ala says to them, فَمَا يَسْأَلُونِي. What are they asking me for? Surely we all ask Allah Jalla wa Ala for things. But what is the greatest thing that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for? Allah Jalla wa Ala said, فَمَا يَسْأَلُونِي. What are they asking me? So the angels, they say, يَسْأَلُونَكَ الْجَنَّةِ. They are asking you for Jannah. This is what they want of Allah. They are asking you for Jannah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَهَلْ رَأَوْهَا. Have they seen it? They are asking me for Jannah, but have they seen Jannah? We are asking Allah Jalla wa Ala for something that we haven't seen. We have heard its greatness and its descriptions, but we have not seen it. So the angels, they say, لا والله يا ربي ما رأوها. No, by Allah, our Lord, they have not seen Jannah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to them, فكيف لو أنهم رأوها. How would they be if they had seen Jannah? They are worshipping Allah like this, and they are asking Allah Jalla wa Ala like this. How would they be if they had seen Jannah? So the angels, they say, لو أنهم رأوها. If they had seen Jannah, كانوا أشد عليها حرصا وأشد لها طلبا وأعظم فيها رغبة. They would desire it more. They would strive for it more. They would ask for it more. This is how they would be if they had seen Jannah. So then Allah Jalla wa Ala says, فَمِمَّ يَتَعَوَّذُونَ. What are they seeking refuge from? What are they seeking protection and salvation and refuge from? So the angels, they say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مِنَ النَّارِ. From the fire. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says to them, وَهَلْ رَأَوْهَا. Have they seen the fire? The angels, they say, لَا وَاللَّهِ يَا رَبِّ مَا رَأَوْهَا. No, by Allah, our Lord, they have not seen the fire. So then Allah Jalla wa Ala says to them, وَكَيْفَ لَوْ أَنَّهُمْ رَأَوْهَا. How would they be if they had seen the fire? We are seeking Allah's protection from the fire. And we are staying away from sins because of the fire. And we do not want to do anything that takes us towards the fire of Jahannam. But we have not seen it. So Allah Jalla wa Ala says to the angels, how would they be if they had seen the fire of Jahannam? So the angels, they say, لَوْ رَأَوْهَا. لَوْ أَنَّهُمْ رَأَوْهَا. If they had seen it, كَانُوا أَشَدَّ مِنْهَا فِرَارًا. They would flee from it even more. وَأَشَدَّ لَهَا مَخَافَةً. And they would fear it even more. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to them, فَأُشْهِدُكُمْ أَنِّي قَدْ غَفَرْتُ لَهُمْ. Allah Jalla wa Ala says to the angels, I hold all of you angels as witness that I have forgiven every single one. Who are these believers? They were the ones who were glorifying and praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were magnifying their creator with words of remembrances that have been taught to us by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah Jalla wa Ala said to them, I hold all of you as witness that I have forgiven every single one of them. فَيَقُولُ مَلَكٌ مِّنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. An angel from the angels, they say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فِيهِمْ فُلَانٌ لَيْسَ مِنْهُمْ إِنَّمَا جَاءَ لِحَاجَةٍ. From amongst them is a man that is not from them. He only came for a need that he had. Let's assume that we are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which we are. And someone came into the masjid because they left their coat, or they left their bag, or they left their book. Was he part of the gathering that was remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No. So the angel, when he heard them, Allah Jalla wa Ala say, I hold all of you to witness that I have forgiven them all. He says, oh Allah, there was a man from amongst them. The man in the gallery who was not from amongst them, he just came for a need. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, هُمُ الْجُلَسَاءُ لَا يَشْقَى بِهِمْ جَلِيسُهُمْ. They are a group of people. Even their companions will not be left in despair. Because they were remembering Allah Jalla wa Ala, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came down and encompassed everyone that was with them. Even if they were not remembering Allah at that time. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to shower His mercy upon the one who was not remembering Him, but He only showered it upon him because he was sitting with those who were remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, imagine how great the mercy of Allah Jalla wa Ala will be for the one who was actually remembering Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This shows us the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the importance of remembrance. Moving our tongues frequently in glorifying Him and praising Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And let us try and implement this in our lives. Have we ever taken a portion of our day out just to reflect أن منبأ الله جل وعلا الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم. Those who remember Allah Jalla wa'ala while they are standing, while they are sitting, while they are lying on their sides, taking out 10 minutes of our day just to say Subhanallah and Alhamdulillah and Allahu Akbar and La ilaha illallah. Taking an hour out of our days just to remember Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala and praise Him and glorify Him and concentrate and really focus and think about our deficiencies and how much Allah Jalla wa'ala has given us. This is remembering Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what will have an effect on our hearts. And if it has an effect on our hearts, then we will see the fruits on our limbs. And we will improve as believers and become beloved to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be merciful to each and every one of us and to show us the greatest level of mercy. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who remember Him frequently in the day and night. And it makes it easier upon our tongues to remember Him and makes this a means for us to stay away from haram and makes this a means for us to become close to Him and beloved to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah Jalla wa'ala to raise us upon the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to allow us to live our entire lives remembering Him and only to take our souls when we are in the highest part of our iman, and to grant us the highest jannah so we can be neighbors of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك وثبت قلوبنا على طاعتك. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم كن لهم ناصرا ومعينا ومؤيدا وظهيرا يا رب العالمين. اللهم طهر المسجد الأقصى من خبث اليهود يا رب العالمين. اللهم أنقذ المسجد الأقصى من اليهود وارزقنا فيه صلاة قبل الممات يا رب العالمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. أقم الصلاة.